going to grind the surface of this plain steel sheet. This is going to be Center Island tabletop in the workshop. And we're going to grind, just design using a 4-inch disc. This is a 50 grit aluminum oxide sanding disc on a Milwaukee grinder. 4.5 inch. And we're just going to go through and we're going to kind of make a swirl design in here. And then after we finalize that, Brad is going to put a house of color candy on this. And then he's going to clear it. We don't know exactly yet what we're going to do for a design. But since this is the first time we're doing this, we're just going to see how it looks and just go off the cuff.
So how was it?
That was fun. What do you think? How does it look? It's it's like a...
I think it looks awesome.
Heavy metal Jackson Pollock.
What happened there, Bill? Heavy metal Jackson Pollock. Yeah, that looks great.
All right, there's the three panels, and
having fun.
Yay! Looks like Eddie. We're ready to clean them off before we put the self-etching clear on it.
We're going to use adhesion promoter.
Adhesion promoter. House of Color.
APO1 adhesive.
All right. And what are we going to use to clean off the surface, Brad?
We're going to use a generic lacquer thinner.
Just a generic. That's what I use to clean my guns.
I can go either side before I stretch. Black. We're using PPG DC3000. It's a fast drying clear. High velocity and it's got a lot of thickness to it. It's a thick clear, which is nice. For something like this to bury those grind marks is what we're going to need. So we're going to apply 2 coats of this. 4-to-1 mix, or then there's the catalyst. It's medium temp. This gallon mix is about $200. So we're gonna mix up. I'm gonna mix up 20 ounces of mixed. And then I'm going to reduce it just a little bit. You know, about that much. That helps it flow better. It looks cloudy, cloudy, cloudy. Then when it's all mixed together, it comes out nice and clear. And here we are. I got Bill Owen here. Put him to work. Got him here using the DA, which is a dual action sander. We are using 500 grit dry sandpaper. What we're doing is we're getting rid of all these nibs, bumps and stuff to get the finish smooth. And once we finish smoothing this out, we lay out our graphics and then we candy it to death. Do about 5 coats of apple red candy on it. Make it look gorgeous. If you look at his DA, he did this whole panel with that one piece, and look how clean it still looks. It still works.
All right, we're looking at 2 different color samples here. What should we pick and why?
This is burgundy. This is brandywine. We should pick brandywine because A, it's a great color, and B, I don't have any apple red on hand. And so what I'm going to do is we're going to spray the tabletop. You can come right here, Bill. Look at this color. Mm-hmm. It's gorgeous. It's apple red plus. It's just, in my eyes, the camera looks different to me, but it looks beautiful. This is more of a wine. Got a little, like a slight, I guess it would be a brown tint to it to make it a little darker. Gorgeous color. If you're going to paint your bike, skip apple red, go with Brandywine. Trust me, you're going to love it.
This is going to be ground metal. Everything else will be red. And this is just a generic skull. This is a little preview of kind of what we're doing. Yeah, it's going to be awesome.
Transfer right, transfer paper.
You can see the logo in there. This is what they use to transfer vinyl logos.
Auto mask, same stuff. This is cheaper.
I've been using this for years. Yeah, I've had no issues. What I'm doing is laying it down so I can put my graphics on it with a pencil. What I'm going to do is draw out my design, finalize it with my Sharpie, X-Acto-knife it out, peel away the excess, paint everything candy apple red.
So this is a rough sketch, so I'll come back with a magic marker to lay out my final lines, cut, weed, candy, clear, and be out.
This is the actual design that I'm using, size, and going with that design. What I did was I drew it out to life size that I wanted. And if you look in the tabletop here, I used a transfer right paper, which is what they use to transfer vinyl graphics. Laid it on there, drew out my design, cut everything out. As you can see, I'll use this to peel back and as a mask. And what you didn't get to see is I took mirror chrome paint, sprayed where the metal parts are gonna be. It's really tough to see. If Bill can get in here, you can see a line right here. It comes up and then it's a circle. This is the joint of the wing. So I'll airbrush details into all this and the details in the parts. This is the parts holding the feathers on. Now the feathers, what I did is I did two different layers. I did it in two different directions to give them some contrast. And I sprayed a gray metallic on each time. And then I took, this is a toolbox lining, help your tools from sliding. And you can see the small pattern in it. Took a reduced black, laid this on top, took a reduced black, sprayed it. Let's say there, you sprayed it. And then you pull it off, and then you got your carbon fiber effect. And I wanted to do two different directions to give a contrast. Plus, it's easier for me to see where one feather ends, the other one starts. So when I shadow everything and highlight, it'll come out perfect.
Dude, let's see this table, man. I'm excited to see it.
That's gonna be your tabletop? Fucking right! Why the fuck not, man?
It sucks having friends that can do this, huh?